Today, I will discuss numerical problem based on viscosity. Problem number one. In a 50 mm long journal bearing arrangement, the clearance between the two at concentric condition is 0.1 mm. The shaft is 20 mm in diameter and rotates at 3000 rpm. The dynamic viscosity of the lubricant used is 0.01 Pascal second, and the viscosity variation in the lubricant is linear. Considering the lubrication to be Newtonian, calculate the frictional torque the journal has to overcome and the corresponding power loss. This is the journal bearing. Length of journal bearing, this is a 50 mm. Diameter, this is a 20 mm. Thickness of oil film, this is a 0.1 mm. RPM, 3000 RPM. For linear velocity profile, velocity gradient du upon dy, this will be equal to change in velocity u upon thickness t. Viscous force F is equal to shear stress into area, shear stress mu into u upon t into area, this will be equal to 2 pi r into l. 2 pi r, this is rotation, and l, this is length of this shaft. Viscous torque, this will be equal to viscous force into r. Viscous force, we know that mu into u by t into 2 pi r l into r. We will put here mu is equal to 0.01 pascal second, this will be equal to 0.01 newton second per meter square. R is equal to 10 mm, this will be equal to 0.01 meter. L is equal to 50 mm, this is a 0.05 meter. Then we know that u 2 pi rn by 60, we put here 2 pi into r 0.01 into n 3000 upon 60, this will be equal to 3.14 meter per second. Then thickness t is equal to 0.1 mm, or we can say 0.0001 meter. Frictional torque t is equal to 0.01 into 3.14 upon 0.0001 into 2 pi into 0.01 into 0.05 into 0.01, then we will get torque is equal to 9.85 into 10 to the power minus 3 newton meter. Then we will get frictional torque T is equal to 9.85 into 10 to the power minus 3 newton meter. Shaft rotates with angular velocity omega, this will be equal to 2 pi n by 60. We will put here 2 pi into 3000 by 60, then we will get 314 radian per second. Power utilized in overcoming the frictional resistance, this will be equal to P is equal to T omega. T is a torque into omega, angular velocity. Put here torque 9.85 into 10 to the power minus 3 newton meter, this value, and angular velocity omega, this is 314 radian per second, then we will get 3.09 watt. This is a problem based on Newton's law of viscosity. If the equation of a velocity profile over a plate is v is equal to 2 into y to the power 2 by 3, in which v is the velocity in meter per second at a distance of y meter above the plate, determine the shear stress at y is equal to 0 and at y is equal to 0.075 meter. Given dynamic viscosity mu is equal to 0.835 newton second per meter square. This is a velocity profile. B is equal to 2 into y to the power 2 by 3. Then we can differentiate this velocity profile du upon dy with the respect of distance. Then we will get velocity gradient du upon dy, this will be equal to 2 into 2 to power 2 into 2 upon 3 into y to the power 2 by 3 minus 1. Then this will be equal to 4 by 3 into y to the power minus 1 by 3. Right? This is the velocity gradient du upon dy. We know that shear stress tau is equal to mu into du upon dy. Mu, this is dynamic viscosity, this is given 0.835 newton second per meter square. We will put here values 0.835 into du upon dy, this will be equal to 4 upon 3 by the power minus 1 by 3. Right? At y is equal to 0, at y is equal to 0, we will put here y is equal to 0, then we will get shear stress tau is equal to infinite. Right? Because this is the 1 upon by the power 1 by 3. So tau will be equal to infinite. Right? At y is equal to 0.075 meter, then we will get tau is equal to 2.64 newton per meter square. Okay. This problem based on Newton's law of viscosity, a cubical block weighing 4.5 newton and having a 40 centimeter edge is allowed to slide down an inclined plane surface making an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal on which there is uniform layer of oil 0.005 centimeter thick. If the expected steady state velocity of the block is 12.5 centimeter per second, determine the viscosity of the oil. Also, express the kinematic viscosity in strokes if the oil has a mass density of 800 kilogram per meter cube. This is a slope, this is a block, weight of the block W, this will be equal to 4.5 newton vertically downward, right? This is inclined plane having 30 degree with the horizontal, right? This component of this weight in the slope direction, this will be equal to W sine alpha, right? Thickness, this is a 0.005 centimeter, this is oil film. Component of the weight of block along the plane, this will equal to W sine alpha. We know that shear stress tau is equal to mu into D upon dy, or we can say mu into D upon dy, this is a velocity gradient, or we can say change in velocity upon thickness of layer. Shearing force F is equal to shear stress into area, right? Shear stress mu into u upon t into area A. This shear force opposes this motion. Force along the plane, this will be equal to W sine alpha under equilibrium condition. W sine alpha, this force along this slope. Right? This will oppose this force, this will be equal to mu into u by t into a. We can say mu is equal to W sin alpha into t upon u a. We will put here all values, u given 12.5 into 10 to the power minus 2, a 0.4 into 0.4, t 0.005 into 10 to the power minus 2, alpha 30 degree, W 4.5 newton, and mu, we will get mu is equal to 0.0056 newton second per meter square, or we can say 0.056 poise. Kinematic viscosity mu upon density, this will be equal to 0.0056 by 800, this will be equal to 7 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second, or we can say 7 into 10 to the power minus 2 centimeter per square second, or we can say 7 into 10 to the power minus 2 strokes, because stroke will be equal to centimeter square per second.